fellow UTK students. I know you are all thrilled that winter break has finally arrived. And I know a lot of you have different plans on how you're going to spend your free time over the break. But I know one thing that almost all of us will do over break. Use social media. I know a lot of you who use social media will use it to promote various social causes. However, this is not a good thing. Because social media activism is taking over and pushing out real world activism. Real world activism is much more effective than activism on social media. There are those who would try to tell you that social media activism is changing the world for the better. But those who try to tell you that are ignoring the many negatives that come with social media activism. Now, I don't want you to just think of activism as this big thing, this national thing that doesn't apply to you. Because it does. It definitely applies to you. Activism has had a huge effect on our very own university right here in Knoxville. I bet you didn't know that many years ago, the torchbearer statue, this same one, our much beloved torchbearer statue, might I add, was once a figure of controversy. According to the University of Tennessee's website, UTK students, quote, marched across campus in protest of the design. Then UT President Andy Holt invited students into his office to discuss the project. Then he agreed to slim down the design and the statue's belly further. And that's how we got the statue that we all know and love today. If it wasn't for these students protesting, real world protests, then we wouldn't have had this statue as we know today. This came at a time when social media didn't even exist, so this proves how effective real-world activism can be. Another much more recent protest that I'm sure all of you are aware of is the Greg Schiano protests. According to ESPN, University of Tennessee fans protested the hiring of Greg Schiano because of, quote, his connection to the Jerry Sandusky era at Penn State. University of Tennessee fans gathered on campus, around 100 of them to be exact. A lot of them holding signs such as this, according to ESPN. Another big way that real world activism affected the hiring is riding on the rock at Tennessee, which, let's just say, had a very anti-Schiano message. The real world protest worked. Eventually, the University of Tennessee's athletic department backed out of hiring Greg Schiano. It was a major win for real-world activists everywhere, and for Tennessee fans everywhere, and it proves the power that real-world activism can have. Another major beneficiary of real-world activism is the Black Lives Matter movement. According to The Wired, in their online article, the Black Lives Matter movement owes a lot of its success to social media. However, this is not true. The way that the Black Lives Matter movement has gained a lot of its notoriety is through protesting, through marching, such as in this picture, and through picketing, through boycotting, and a bunch of different things that involve real-world activism. And what The Wire ignores in their online article is that civil rights activists have created a lot of change even before the invention of social media. For example, the one and only Martin Luther King Jr., who created so much change for the better in this world, he did this all the time before social media even exists. Another big example of how activism can exist and is better without social media is the National Anthem protests. The National Anthem protests were started by this man, Colin Kaepernick, who started at first sitting and later, as you can see in this picture, kneeling in protest of this country's problem with racial injustice. And in his kneeling, he was able to create, according to the Washington Post, quote, year-long discussions both inside and outside the league. These discussions eventually became so big and so prominent that eventually the President of the United States, Donald Trump, issued a comment on them. These protests were highly effective, and they created so much discussion about racial injustice in this country, and they once again prove how effective real world activism can be. Now, I know a lot of you are probably saying, so, why does this matter? Social media activism, real world activism, whatever. I don't care. But you should care. Because we are all part of the next generation. A generation that needs to make the world a better place. A generation that needs to make a difference. A generation that is supposed to leave this world better for our kids. A generation that needs to make a change. And how do you make a change, you ask? Well, I'm glad you asked. You make a change through real-world activism. Daisy Pedro once said, vote, volunteer, march, organize, donate. These are all great examples of real-world activism, and they're all highly effective. The Torchbearer protests, the National Anthem protests, the Black Lives Matter protests, the Greg Schiano protests, all are examples of real-world activism having a major impact on this country and on our own very own university. And they prove beyond a shadow of a doubt how effective real-world activism can be. I hope this all convinces you to go out and to make the world a better place through real-world activism. Thank you.